Seventh, eighth, yeah. Seventh, eighth for Fnatic. Not terrible, you know, top eight team. They 2-0'd them. They 2-0'd NIP, who we just saw being knocked out by Evil Geniuses. They tip him right after he messes up at top with the wave. Okay, Fissure will be there. No one. Adaptor Strike. Oh my god. Nisha is actually on the wrong side of the Fissure to be able to get the kill out. No one should tip someone. That's where you tip Yapzor again. Simultaneously, Puppy does get brought down at bottom by 9 Pasha. Zai is gonna get Spirit Lance, but because he has his Ring of Health, it's unlikely he's gonna die here. Ramzes might try. Does have level 3 into the Phantom Rush. He's gonna go Doppelganger forward. He wants to really find Zai. And he's already used the Phantom Rush. The Spirit Lance, will it be there? It will. One more right click is all he needs. And Ramzes does secure the kill onto the Centaur. All of it thanks to the Stampede in particular. So they need to try and deal with Ramzes as soon as possible. Ramzes is actually going to get another kill. Zai is dead. Zai is very dead. Spirit Lance will catch him. Like, Ramzes is going to get this kill. He's going to doppelganger and break the trees. There we go. Easy kill. Puppy does show up now. He does get the Maledict off onto a ton of these illusions. However, Ramzes is in the trees right now. Swaps back his TP scroll. Yapso looking for him. Yapso is going to find him. And he's going to interrupt the TP. Ramzes is dead. Feels bad, man. We see now Zai. Spirit Lance thrown out onto his face. There will be a jump in from mid one. The Hoofstomp will be there. They want to kill Roger first and foremost because they understand that if Roger lives, PL will too. And they get the one kill mid one, looking to chase down Ramzes. Needs one more attack. Can he get off the tree dance into the Primal Spring? Tries to evade the Avalanche using the Doppelganger. And Axe, solo. Primal Spring will be there with the waveform. They're going to easily find this kill. And Nisha picks it up quite quickly. Stampede was used by Zai towards the bottom side of the map. Ramzes is going on to Roger. The coconut bouncing off. And have they gotten off the Maledict? Or else Ramzes will not die here. He's very low on HP. Mid one does show up. Drops a Wukong's command as well. Ramzes is in trouble now. He's being healed up still by Roger. But then the LSA landed onto mid one. Mid one gets off the Boundless Strike. But the heals are there too much onto Ramzes. Ramzes still up. No one though. Surrounded. The Guru Blade will fly out. There's the Echo Slam from Yapzor though. Bringing down the Wisp as well as the Lina. And we see Ramzes is going to be so low as well. He's going to die too. Double kill for Yapzor. The call from Solo to give him additional armor. But now Nisha also shows up, but not going to try and go for this kill. Just needs his team to create space for him. And thus far, they are attempting to do so. Bounty runes will be claimed. Puppy, his coconut flying in different directions. Wukong's command does get dropped down. Death Ward going to get triggered out as well. Solo almost going to get brought down. Mid one needed the Wukong's command. If they had a Maledict drone, Solo would be dead right now. Waveform forward coming in. Nisha, LSA, he steals it away from no one. No one now. Dragon slaved up in the Adaptive Strike with the coconut bouncing forward. And Yapzor were able to get a kill onto no one. Zai does end up falling on the top side of the map. They are going to be the ones that decide to smoke. Mid one is probably going to die here. Yep, Pasha were able to get the toss up onto Solo with the Berserker's Call. They get the Laguna Blade out and mid one won't die. We do see the Maledict drop down onto Pasha as well as the Death Ward. So Pasha taking a lot of damage. Is he going to die from this? Only level 1 Maledict, so he's actually fine. Yules up into the air. Ramzes chasing down Puppy. Puppy will be the next on the fall. Solo doesn't have the Blink Dagger, but still chasing. Zai slowed down with the Battle Hunger. No one might be able to get off the LSA. He does succeed in doing so. And they get the toss forward of the IO. They really want to find this kill. Solo's going to look for the call. Doesn't even need it. Just Cunning Blades him. And Virtus Pro, they take the impetus. They go forward. It might be a fight breaking out here at bottom. This Bounty Rune could be contested with VP smoked up as 3. They've already laid out some vision. They see Nisha. They really wanted to reveal this Blink Dagger. And the Hoof Stomp will connect onto Axe. Boundless Strike onto 2 heroes. Solo is actually going to die very early on the back. And will they be able to catch anybody else though? They know that no one is in the vicinity right now. The Stampede used by the team. Fissure will be there onto no one. No one waveform through. And mid one will be able to get the kill. Stampede now used. Oh my god, they found no one. And they're also going to get the tier 2 tower. Because there's a Siege Wagon here. And mid one doing all the damage in the world with this Echo Saber. And they're pushing out this bottom lane as well with Nisha and Zai. They don't have access to the Stampede right now to be able to use that to get away with. Fissure will make sure that Pasha and Solo can't easily catch up. Two of the tough heroes. Wukong's command by mid one. They want to try and get this kill. Will there be an Echo Slam by Yapzor? He's going to go in onto the PL. PL going to lose his life inside the Wukong's command. The command ring will be able to get this kill. At the same time, Axe did die as well. Roger making his way away He's looking for somebody to get the tether onto him. Nisha, though, will find him, snipe him with the adaptive strike. Monkey King, mid-run, is already sitting on a tree. The coconut will bounce, will slow down Pasha. And they do get the stun out onto Zai. Poppy, slowed down, destroyed. They take his life away. The homestorm coming in from Zai onto the other side of the fight. And here is going to be Nisha jumping in with his BKB, using the stolen call. Adaptive strike, they are able to get this kill onto the IO. Echo slam going out around Ramzy's. Ramzy's in trouble right now, but the damage coming in from Laguna Blade onto Nisha. Nisha morphs back into the morphling. And the Morphling is going to be able to get the kill onto Pasha down outside the base. Fissure will catch the Ramzy's. They're going to be bouncing around with this coconut. They do not have any damage to kill like Ramzy's right now, but they do bring down Solo. The Stampede, oh no, it comes out. And they are going to be able to find Ramzy's. They chase him down, they get the kill. A buyback from Solo. And they just call GG. Virtus Pro recognize when it's over. So he was correct to ban out the Pasha Tiny. But it's going to be an even more legendary thing. I haven't been treated to a Pasha Phoenix in the offlane in quite some time. It's always weird to me how good Puppy is. Like his decision making, man. It's just so legit. Spark Wraith laid out onto Roger after the Fire Blast. They might be able to find the kill onto Roger because they also fluxed him. But it looks like the counterplay might be happening too. Roger. Double Edge will be there. Oh, here comes Yapzor. Oh, Yapzor helping them get a kill onto Pasha. Pasha no longer has access to the Icarus Dive. And now, because of the Fire Blast from Puppy, enables them to get that kill. Nisha doesn't have any mana for a new Spark Wraith to be thrown out. But Yapzor, he sees where Roger is. And they're going to surround him with the CS. It's going to be a Hoofstomp. Mango popped Roger. Nisha got jabated into that situation. That was actually a really bad play. Two things that it's useful against. The Fire Blast as well as the Lift. And ultimately, there's so many ways to pop it. They're going to get the lift out onto Solo. He gets banished. Puppy will be here looking for the Fire Blast. They get it off onto Solo. They want to try and kill the one first. Hoofstomp will be there. And the life drain as well allows them, after the double edge, to get the kill onto Puppy. Goes directly the way of Virtus Pro. And Ramzy's not done just yet. He proceeds towards bottom. He's got no one with him. So they're like, well, we can actually try and take this. But we do have Puppy looping around on the backside of the fight. Oh my goodness, look at the damage they're taking from this Nether Ward. And Ramzy's just going to rush forward and they get this kill. Nisha TP's in, but this might be a mistake from him. Flux laid out as well as the Static Link. With the life drain, though, coming in from no one allows him to get the kill onto Nisha. The waveform forward by Ramzy's. He stole away the Warfling's form. They almost get this kill onto no one thanks to the Swashbuckle flying through and the Heart Piercer. The Stampede coming out from Virtus Pro. And the waveform forward allows Puppy to get yet another kill. So three heroes. Stampede used, actually. The Phoenix Supernova will pop and they get the kill onto mid one. They will also be able to bring down the Ogre Major. Yapzor will be able to pop the Shrine, trying to keep himself safe and alive. He just wants to lift. 3 more seconds. He's stolen the attribute shift. And he will be able to lift one. Oh, he's still Stampede again, but it's already been used.
That's not right.
He will not be able to sustain this. And it will end up going down. And now we see them waveforming forward, looking towards Zai. Shield Crash will come out. No one at the same time. Able to kill Nisha. How? Oh my god. No one Pugna, guys. I wouldn't say they're making it look easy, but they're making it very, 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 very competitive across the series. And you see Zhai. Zhai is trying to get this kill, but needs to swashbuckle up to safety. Now he's doing the whole storm onto two heroes on the back line of the fight. Roger able to catch Puppy and Yapzor. They've already brought down Zhai. Poison Star standing onto Yapzor, onto Puppy. Puppy will die from one more right click coming in from Ramzy's. Yapzor manages to steal waveform, uses it to get himself out of danger. And they will force a buyback from the Ogre. Oh, excuse me, from the Ogre Magi. And OD does go back for the 4-star. Okay, this is kind of dangerous. Astros himself, there will be a Stampede. Rolling Thunder does get used. Here comes Yapzor. They lift up Roger, put him in the air. They have Stampede themselves now. And are they going to go further for this fight? Oh, Swashbuckle up onto the high ground. Roger is still alive. He's actually going to turn around and use the double edge to bring down the OD. They also lose Zai as well. Puppy's going to die too to the Fire Spirits from Pasha. Yo, Seam Secret. Buy it off. They bite off a fight, they cannot chew that shit. They get chewed the hell up themselves. Right now, they seem to lack the ability to do so. Ramzy's, this is his home. He gets weaved up as well. And here comes Rolling Thunder on the back side of the fight. Okay, yep, so it gets jumped upon right now by Roger. Magnetic Field was used. Roger falling very low. They will be able to kill him. No, the Shallow Grave keeps him alive. The Supernova, will it die? Yes, it will. But it does cost the Tempest Double's life. Waveform forward by Ramsey's able to get a double kill by bringing down Nisha. Mid one, alive for a moment, but unfortunately not that many moments. Even the Sanity's Eclipse, not enough to save his life. This feels like GG. Feels like Randy's is actually too strong right now. He turns into the Ogre Magi for a moment, turns back into himself. He is taking quite a bit of damage. The Heart Piercer does go out. And they lift him. They have Ramsey's in their sights. He manages to shift his attributes though. And Spark Wraith. So far all they've taken is the Ranger Axe. They actually haven't been able to grab more. Buyback from mid one will scare them away, however. Or will it? They have to be afraid. Team Secret, they know how much VP loves their fake backs. So they can't leave the base. Puppy with mid one. They could potentially try and make this jump, but the Morphling right now, Ramsey's, is about to try and take this Rax. So the Magnetic Field from Nisha will protect those Rax for now. Puppy TP's back into the base. Mid one might become visible. Fire Blast flying out onto him. They lift him back. Actually, they might be able to get this kill. No, Ramsey's turns back into the real form. Doesn't use the Magnetic Field anymore. And the Sunray heals him up. And Nisha, just making sure he can't get in. The jump will be there for Roger. They want to try and go for Nisha directly. They're going to be a swing in as well from Pasha. Supernova gets dropped down. They are able with the Adaptor Strike to get the kill onto the Arc Warden on the side of the fight. The Supernova will trigger off. It doesn't stun anybody, but mid one right now is being chased down by the Sunray, and he's going to die. Next to four will be Nisha. No, that's Ramsey's actually. That's the real one. Doesn't matter though, because the rest of the team has indeed died, and Team Secret call GG, and VP will take game two. This time they're the ones that make it look easy. Man, they crushed that Arc Warden. Wow, they destroyed Arc Warden. Woo! That was something. I'm down. This is a hero that's gonna buy BKB, which you absolutely need in this game, versus the Team Secret lineup. Some impeccable teamfight to add onto what they already have with the Phoenix, as well as the Earthshaker. A hero that can beat out mid one in the lane. If you go for the Wex build on this Invoker, you're pretty good against Ember Spirit, and the Tornado immediately dispels the Flame Guard that can be put to bear by mid one. But they will not be able to actually kill anybody now. Metamorphosis used up by the Terror Blade. Reflection out onto Zai. Early level Reflection with the Fire Blast as well. And they should be able to find the kill. Zai is spaced out by Ramsey's. And Ramsey's will end up falling down. First Blood going the way of Virtus Pro. Pasha. Oh. Puppy has there's a history on Roger right now. He's going to try to bring down Puppy. He's going to succeed in doing so. And he's just going to TP away as well. Everything is a-okay for him. We see now Icarus die from Pasha. Top side of the map, he just wants to leave. Doesn't want to actually get encroached upon right now. There is that pretty nice fissure from Roger onto Puppy, ensuring that they get the kill. Silencer dead again. Unfortunately, in the midst of getting that kill, they weren't able to guarantee that they kill Nisha as well. Mid one, smoke. Slowed down by the cold snap. But he ends up being able to escape. Yapso though, not so lucky. Brought down by Solo as well as Ramsey's in the metamorphosis mode for the Terror Blade. I guess Pasha knows he can't really lane against mid one right now. A single steering chains and he dies. That was skill, alright. Your skill. And Pasha is dodging everything though. Has he just baited mid one to his doom? He might have just done so. There's the cold snap. Oh, the unfortunate timing of the invoker showing up right then and there with a tornado, tossing mid one into the air. Does he have sunstrike though? And it is actually going to be this Wex invoker. Mid one will dodge the sunstrike. Should be fine. The increased movement speed from no one though, closing the gap. Mid one will be able to get to the shrine however. Nisha at the very least will be able to finish off the necro book. This game going much better than game number 2 for this Arc Warden. In large part due to the fact that, yeah sure, although Ember Spirit is behind no one actually going to get another kill onto Puppy at top, and he will succeed in doing so. Mid one, meantime, is actually the one that kills the Terror Blade at bottom. makes it difficult for TB to even survive long enough to guarantee the Sunder. Because that's the thing, it takes a while before TB has high amounts of HP, even when he has armor, Zai, Stampede, running past no one. No one will not be able to trigger off the EMP onto Zai. Erstwhile though, at bottom, mid one, in some trouble, needs to be able to get out of here with the Remnant. He Remnants through, but there's still a TP coming in from the Phoenix. Pasha wants to try and close the gap. Nice fissure from Roger. No, that was Yapso fissure. He stole it from Roger. In fact, they're going to be able to escape. Oh no, the Echo Slam used. Mid one. They want this kill too badly to be able to let him go. They even commit the ultimate from the Earthshaker. This game is going to buy a Blink Dagger. I think he looks and he's like, okay, yeah, I'll buy a Blink, guys. Don't worry. We need some initiation. Can they kill him, though? They spot him. Nah, he's dead, for sure. The tornado doesn't connect onto him, but they've already got on out the Urn of Shadows. And they see Solo here with the Fire Blast ready to trigger it out. Oh, actually, he juked quite nicely. He's going to be able to escape this. Oh my god, Zai, what a player. And now mid one. Here with Poppy, they want to try to get some revenge for this. They are able to get the Searing Chains out, but the Flame Guard still flying for mid one. Global Silence will be used up right now. But I'm not sure. That was actually a really bad logo. They're going to lose this fight. They have to back away. They now get the Urn of Shadows with the double Fire Blast going out onto Ember Spirit. Ember will be able to lay out the Remnant with the double Searing Chains. It's still alive for the time being. They are able to get the lift off onto the Terror Blade, putting him into a kind of a bad position. Yapso looking for a good angle to be able to throw out the tornado, use it onto Ramses. It's not going to be comboed up with the Hoof Stomp though. And there's going to be a triple Remnant forward from mid one. Mehran fissured right now, kept alive still. Urn of Shadows has yet to bring him down. He has an Arcane Rune. Roger trying to close the gap so that he can get off the Echo Slam. And mid one goes back into this one, but they're going to get this kill for Nisha. And somehow, Nisha and Yapso are the only ones that died throughout all that. Look how many spells were used by everybody. Now, we are just following the progress of this Earthshaker Blink Dagger because I really believe this is going to be super important for this game. The lift back onto Solo, mid one. Watch yourself, buddy. He does have a haste rune though. Gonna try and deal with Ramses as well. Wow, look at the damage Ramses puts out onto Yapso. Easy kill there for the Terror Blade. They get that kill. Mid one gonna be forced to get out of dodge. They even stampede for him. That stampede atop almost saved Puppy's life too, but the last right click from no one will pursue him within the trees and end his life there. Zai now gonna TP bottom. Doesn't have a stampede, but with him just standing here as a beefcake, makes it less likely they're gonna jump for this. Ramses still wants to find this Roger with the fissure, but whose Yule Scepter was that? Was that Roger's one? It was, to make sure that they... That wasn't Roger's one, Pasha's Yule's. Oh, Echo Slam flies out with the Blink Dagger just being bought. Yapso's in trouble. Enchant Stolen does get stolen by Rubick, but Yapso... And Yapso will now trigger off the Fire Spirits as they cool down, throwing them... Trying to affect the Terror Blade with this. And they're just wasting a lot of their time. Also creating space for Ember Spirit down at bottom to be able to push out that tower. And the constant usage of the Spark Wraith, making this very, very annoying. Tornado come down to several heroes. There's going to be the Global Silence. Supernova is dropped down. It might get destroyed very early on. It does get brought down. And Ramses does take the tower, however. Roger looking forward to get off a stun onto somebody. Unfortunately, he's going to get turned around upon. Puppy will be cold snapped and probably lose his life here with one more right click. He hasn't died actually as of yet. The Sunstrike is going to be what kills him, but he is able to steal away some intelligence because of the fact that they bring down the Roger Earthshaker. Still needs to do some work to catch up to the Invoker, but it is entirely possible. No one erstwhile on the Invoker does have access to the Aghanim Scepter. He's going to put the Cold Snap EMP on a Puppy. Puppy's dead. Woo! I guess Puppy got the D ward before he died, but no, hashtag not worth. Now into the Roshan pit we go. They're going to throw out the Bloodlust onto this Terror Blade. God damn. And they give him Alacrity as well. Look how fast TB is hitting. And they are trying to claim this Roche. Mid one, going to get Tornado. There's a fissure there as well from Roger. I think they need to be aware that something might be happening here. Roche is going to fall, however. And Zai, oh no. Zai gets the Roche. Are they going to get the Aegis? Okay, they're going to be able to still get it back for Ramses. Supernova will pop, stunning up Zai. Fire Blast will go out onto our Ember Spirit, but Ember will be able to zip away. Yep, so got the lift off, but will still die. Trapped in the trees by this. He got off the stolen Sunder, but... Oh, yeah, he got Sundered, rather. Pasha got 15, he does. So he got that Fire Spirits DPS. Didn't go Midas this game, so collecting gold a little bit more slowly. As a result, his Shiva's guard is delayed. Okay, the jump in from Zai. They want to try and bring down Roger. Roger falling very low. The Global Silence will be out here. Even through the BKB, they've managed to get one kill onto Roger thus far. Magnetic Field will be laid out by Nisha. Ramzes is not doing any damage. Zai will eventually die. And who else is going to get brought down? The Supernova won't pop. Puppy has died as well. And Midone, with the Sleight of Fist, is trying to do as much as humanly possible. But Terrorblade feels like he's too strong at the moment. And Nisha... that fighting like has just started off in a weird place. Okay, they will be able to at least find the first life away from the Terrorblade. So the Aegis is removed from him. Midone, able to get the chains out onto the TB. TB being right-clicked down by the Tempest Double. Tempest Double is going to get destroyed, however. But the heals being there from the Sunray. They didn't finish this D-Ward on the high ground, so there's still vision here that they need to deal with. Pasha's gonna die. Unless he supernovas, but there is no supernova. The Tempest Double's gonna kill him. Or it's gonna be Zai who's showing up. There's the Spark Wraith. The Spark Wraith hits, and Nisha able to secure the kill with that one. Feels bad, man. Mid lane, Ember Spirit, mid one. Does he have a remnant to dodge back to? It doesn't seem like it. He needs to try and get himself out of here. It's actually going to be able to kill mid one, or no one rather, thanks to the help of Yapzo. Yapzo also steals the Bloodlust, allows them to bring down this ogre. Oh my god. Yapzo kills no one. He kills solo. They're not going to get this bounty rune that Ramzes just stole from them. And why is Ramzes so fast? Jesus, 450 move speed, wow. And no one can't walk past this, because he knows it'll trigger it. And now they're losing really badly because they have 4 bounty runes, okay, at least 3, that are taken away from them. And Team Secret will also claim the first roach that has a refresher shard, or will they? Pasha gets off his supernova onto a high ground. Mid one in trouble, gonna get caught. All the global silence will create enough space for Mid one to be able to escape because he gets off the large amount of damage, and they're gonna drop a spec rate as well as the damage from the flux. Ramzes will turn around now, BKB activated for him. He can't Lotus Orb onto, he can't use the Sunder onto the Lotus Orb Zai. So he's gonna be forced back from this fight. And the two supports got eviscerated by Mid one. Sunstrike will be there, only takes down one of these Necro units. Okay, we do see they get the catch right now. They have managed to find the Earthshaker, and Roger will die again. Lol, Midone gets his CP cancelled out. So they might be like, oh, okay, fine. You guys on our box. Okay, they get the Hex out onto our Ogre. Solo gonna get jumped on by Zai. Zai putting him in trouble. They're gonna get the Sleight of Chains through him. And Ramzes is inside the Metamorphosis. And the Spark Wraith will secure the kill. And Puppy helping out as well. The Supernova laid down by the Phoenix. 4-star forward, keeping Puppy alive. Sunstrike won't connect onto any heroes. Oh, Hoofstorm going onto Roger. They found the Earthshaker again. He is dead for sure. Now we see Ramzes get silenced up inside his BKB form. He was still fighting here, going up on Zai. Sunder will connect onto him. Gets lifted up right now. BKB has expired. Can't reuse it now. Fissure stolen by the Rubik. Yapzo ensuring that they get the kill onto Terrorblade. And now we see the Hoofstorm laying out onto no one. No one. Spark Wraith on him. He will die as soon as he drops down to the floor. There's no way he can escape. This Cataclysm will be used up by him right now. He's going to be forced to buy back as well to come back into this one. Ramzes, at the forefront of the fight, has bought back. Pasha doesn't have the supernova. The Fissure catches 2. Zai's Hoofstomp is going to catch 2 as well. Pasha, his dieback is going to be followed by no one's dieback as well. And Team Secret, they have done it. They have secured their place in the grand finals of the Kuala Lumpur Major. There is no way that Virtus Pro is going to be able to stop them from this one now. Their destiny is in their hands. In fact, Ramzes is going to be the last one that gets caught. He'll be able to dodge the whole stomp, but not the lift coming in from Yapzo. Oh, they lift him and toss him onto the wrong side of the fissure. Roger, you've just doomed your friend. And now they're going to kill Ramzes just before the game ends. Actually, game just ends. Team Secret destroy the Ancient, and GG, well played. Wow.